We want to turn now to the long, slow process of reopening shuttered government offices. Here's the latest right now. With the tax filing season set to begin Monday, a government watchdog group overseeing the IRS is warning about a major backlog at the agency. The Washington Post reporting the National Taxpayer Advocate told House staffers it could take a year or more for the IRS to catch up. The status of the State of the Union is still up in the air. House Speaker Nancy Pelosi saying she's working with the White House to come up with a new date for the president's address, but insists it will not take place this Tuesday. What will be happening on Tuesday? The Smithsonian Museums will be opening their doors once again. The shutdown cost the complex of 19 museums $1 million in revenue each week it was closed.
And a new ABC News Washington Post poll just released this morning finds support for House Democrats' investigations of President Trump. It shows 57% of Americans support House Democrats using their authority to investigate possible collusion between the Trump campaign and Russia, while 61% of Americans also say they support the investigations into possible financial ties between Trump and foreign governments.
Meanwhile, overnight, President Trump taking aim at the special counsel over his latest move, the indictment of Trump's longtime associate and advisor, Roger Stone. George Stephanopoulos is standing by for more on this, but let's start here with ABC News White House correspondent Tara Palmieri, who's right there at the White House. Tara, good morning to you.
Good morning, Dan. That's right. The president is lashing out at the special counsel, but this story is not going away. In fact, it will take center stage again this week when Roger Stone is arraigned on Tuesday.
President Trump's longtime political advisor, Roger Stone, out on bail and firing back at special counsel Robert Mueller.
This was an egregious overreach by Mr. Mueller. The FBI director who had to have approved this raid should, in my opinion, be fired over it because it was unwarranted. I guess it's an effort to intimidate me, but I am not intimidated.
As part of the special counsel's investigation into possible Russian collusion with the Trump campaign, Mueller indicted Stone on 7 counts, including obstruction, witness tampering, and lying to Congress. One of Stone's associates, Jerome Corsi, admitting that his hours of testimony with the special counsel may have led to Stone's indictment.
I'm going to say what's in the indictment is accurate. If called, I will testify to what's there. I won't differ one word from it. It's correct. Now, if that helps Roger Stone or hurts him, let the chips fall where they may.
In a statement, Speaker Nancy Pelosi says the House will continue to exercise their constitutional oversight responsibility, adding that Stone's indictment proves, quote, there was a deliberate, coordinated attempt by Trump campaign officials to influence the 2016 election and subvert the will of the American people. These court documents filed by the special counsel cast Stone as an intermediary between the Trump campaign and WikiLeaks, which published emails Russia stole from the Democratic National Committee and Hillary Clinton's campaign chairman, John Podesta.
WikiLeaks. I love WikiLeaks.
Prosecutors allege Stone was in contact with the organization during the lead up to the election, seeking information that would be damaging to Hillary Clinton. Mueller does not indicate who it was that directed the campaign official to reach out to Stone, but Stone now denies having any contact with WikiLeaks founder Julian Assange and claims he did not relay information to the campaign about the hacks.
The allegation that two campaign officials instructed me or inquired of me about WikiLeaks is false.
And now the president is already distancing himself from Roger Stone, a self-described dirty trickster who advised the campaign until 2015 when he departed. President Trump tweeted, quote, Roger Stone didn't even work for me anywhere near the election. Witch hunt. Dan.
Tara Palmieri at the White House. Thank you. For more on this, as advertised, let's bring in our chief anchor, George Stephanopoulos, who's going to be hosting this week later
this
morning.
Guys.
Good morning, sir. So I know you're going to have Roger Stone on the show this morning. Unclear whether he'll wear his beret. How much of a threat, if any, do you think Stone's indictment poses to the president?
I don't think we know yet. I mean, it was in Tara's piece that the most interesting paragraph in the indictment is the one that says a senior campaign official was directed to talk to Roger Stone about WikiLeaks. Who directed a senior campaign official? Who is the senior campaign official? If one of those two people is Donald Trump, that could pose some kind, it could at least raise questions for the president. But if I were Roger Stone, I'd be a little bit worried about that tweet from the president last night. You know, in the past several weeks, in fact, the last time Roger Stone was on our show back in December, the president went out tweeting very much in support of Roger Stone. Now he's saying he didn't even work for me for very long. In fact, Roger Stone is Donald Trump's longest serving political advisor. They were introduced by Roy Cohn almost three decades ago, and he's never been fully out of Donald Trump's orbit.
So this could be a sign of trouble, if not at least distancing. So let's talk about the ABC News Washington Post poll that Eva was talking about a few moments ago. One of the other nuggets from that poll is that 6 in 10 Americans say they would support the Democrats in Congress going after Donald Trump's tax returns. Do you think the Democrats are likely to do that? And if they do it, can they actually get those returns?
They've already said they will. And there's a law that gives the chairman of the House Ways and Means Committee, now run by Democrats, the chairman is a man named Richard Neal, or the chair of the Joint Tax Committee, the ability to request those tax returns. Now, it's very possible, even though the law is very, very clear, that the administration, Donald Trump, the Treasury Department will try to fight that, will take it to the courts. How that will work out, I don't know for sure, although I said the law is quite clear. I think what the Democrats are trying to do is to first lay the groundwork for why they want the tax returns, what connection it might have to public policy or possible violations of the Emoluments Clause, say, of the Constitution by Donald Trump, or perhaps corruption in the past before they actually make the request.
Got to leave it there, George. Thank you very much. Really appreciate it. I want to remind everybody, George has a big show this morning. Be sure to tune in to This Week later this morning for George's Sunday morning exclusive with Roger Stone following his indictment by the special counsel just days ago. Plus, this morning, the chairman of the House Intelligence Committee, Congressman Adam Schiff, will come on the show to respond. It's all coming up on This Week right here on ABC. George, thanks again.
Guys.
Appreciate it.
Hi, everyone. George Stephanopoulos here. Thanks for checking out the ABC News YouTube channel. If you'd like to get more videos, show highlights, and watch live event coverage, click on the right over here to subscribe to our channel. And don't forget to download the ABC News app for breaking news alerts. Thanks for watching.